أنشدت بسم الله ثم الحمد له فالله أهل الحمد إن الحمد له يا ربي أنت كلما رزقتني رأيت خيرا سابغا لحد له بك الرجاء وحبكم ربي سرى في القلب ثم زانه فجمله أنت الذي سترت ما يعيبني وجدت لي
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد. We were talking about the verse إهدنا الصراط المستقيم, and we mentioned that the word صراط in and of itself implies a very clear, a very level, a very large path. And what this implies, my dear brothers and sisters, is that there are a lot of people on this path. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us that you are not the first Muslim. You are not the only Muslim. There are many people before you and along with you and after you that will come on the sirat. Also, the word sirat, as we said, implies straightness. And this also implies that there is only one sirat to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the standard belief of really all religions up until modernity. In our times, unfortunately, there's a new ideology, and that is all paths lead to God. And this is, the fancy word for this is perennialism. In other words, the claim is all religions lead to God. And no matter what you are, it is legitimate. From our perspective, there's only one theology that is correct, and that is the religion of Islam. Inna deena inda Allahi al-Islam. The only religion acceptable to Allah is Islam. So there's one Sirat al-Mustaqim. And that is why whenever Allah talks about the truth, it is in the singular. And when He talks about falsehood, it is in the plural. Allah Azza wa Jal says that Allah will guide you to the Nur, singular, from the Zulumat, plural. There are many Zulumat, there's one Nur. Allah Azza wa Jal says, don't follow the subul, but come to the sabil. Don't follow the wrong paths, come to the correct path. So the correct path is in the singular. And this is demonstrated by the word sirat, and the fact that even the word sirat does not occur in the Quran in the plural. And the falsehood, the evil paths are mentioned in the plural. Dhulumat is in the plural. The subul that are wrong is in the plural. And our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, in that famous hadith, he drew a straight line. And he said, "Hada siratu Allahi al-mustaqim." This is the straight sirat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he drew lines coming from this. So this is a diagram. He's giving a schematic interpretation of what is sirat al-mustaqim. On the sand, with a stick, he's drawing it. And he drew paths outside of this line. And he said, these are the paths of misguidance. So how many paths of misguidance? Many. How many paths of guidance? One. And this is demonstrated in the word sirat. Also the word sirat, it implies, as we said, that the path is clear. It's not obscure. It's not difficult. It is crystal clear. And therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, we Muslims have a very beautiful belief. And that is, and it comes in handy to mention this when we're giving da'wah to non-Muslims. We believe that anybody who wants to find the sirat will be able to find it. I.e., anybody who wants to know the truth will find the truth. The truth is not obscure. Allah did not hide the truth in quizzes, in convoluted language, in difficult logic. The truth is crystal clear. The sirat is massive. It's one. It's clear. You're not going to get lost if you want to find the sirat. The sirat is right there in the middle. So we believe that anybody who wants to know the truth, any non-Muslim, if you are sincere, oh non-Muslim, we say to him, if you are sincere, then you will find the sirat, because there's only one sirat that is crystal clear. Now here we have a question, and that is that we are reading Fatiha as Muslims, most of us. In fact, the Surah Al-Fatiha is recited 99.99% by Muslim, and we already have hidayah. We already are guided. So why, somebody will say, am I asking for hidayah when I'm already a Muslim? We are saying ihdina sirat al-mustaqim, and as Muslims we believe we are on the sirat. So why are we asking for hidayah while we are upon hidayah? This is a question that some people can say, and the response to this is very simple. Hidayah, guidance, is not like a light switch which is either on or off. If you know mathematics, it's not binary, 0 or 1. No, hidayah is multiple levels. Hidayah has many different darajat. And no matter how much hidayah you have, you can always gain more hidayah. What is the evidence for this? The Quran is very clear that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا زَادَهُمْ هُدًى. Those who were guided, we guided them even more. زَادَهُمْ هُدًى. Allah says about the people of the cave, the young men, إِنَّهُمْ فِتْيَةٌ آمَنُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ. Then what does Allah say? وَزِدْنَاهُمْ هُدًى. They were a group of young men. They believed in their Lord. So we blessed them. وَزِدْنَاهُمْ. We gave them more hidayah. So they had iman. Yet Allah gave them more hidayah. And so when we say اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ, even if we have some hidayah, we always want more hidayah. There is no end to the amount of hidayah. So much so that our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he is the one that has the most hidayah, in tahajjud he would make dua to Allah, اللهم اهدني لما اختلف فيه من الحق بإذنك. Oh Allah, give me hidayah. Make me guided amongst all of the issues that mankind differ about. I want to have hidayah. So our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who doesn't just have hidayah, he is the hadi. He is the one who gives hidayah by the permission of Allah. Still, he's asking for more hidayah. So do you understand? Nobody can say, oh, I have some hidayah. Why am I asking for more? Even a Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he is not just the one who's muhtad, he is hadi. And hadi means the one who's giving hidayah. He is giving hidayah, yet he's asking Allah for more hidayah. So every one of us says, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. And we also said that the plural here, اهدنا, we mentioned this yesterday, that the plural, and I want to reiterate, 2 days ago we mentioned it, I want to reiterate here another benefit, that we recite the Fatiha in the singular. I am one and I say اهدنا. Allah didn't reveal اهدني, even though I am reciting. Why? For multiple reasons. First and foremost, so that the connection with the ummah is reinforced. So that you realize, O Muslim, that you are not alone. You have a large group, a fraternity. You have a polity. You have a group that you must be interested in, and they must be interested in you. So, O Muslim, do not be selfish when you make dua. Make dua for everyone. Don't just make dua for yourself. Ihdina. We want hidayah for all. Not just for you. Not just for me. Not just for my children. The Muslim cares about the other Muslims. The Muslim has a connection. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, whoever makes dua for another, an angel will say ameen, and may you get it as well. So when we say ihdina, our niyyah isn't just selfish, me, myself and I. Our niyyah is, oh Allah, guide the ummah. Oh Allah, guide all of mankind. We want guidance for everybody. Because our religion is not just about selfishness. Our religion, as our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that none of you believes until you care for your brother what you care for yourself. So اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. What is this sirat? What is this sirat? The final verses will explain. And we'll start explanation today, and tomorrow inshallah we'll finish this series of verses. Then we'll go back and summarize some issues about Surah Al-Fatiha. What is this sirat? اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. This is the sirat of those whom you have shown your favors to. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. Now, what is a favor? What is a ni'mah? In Arabic, a ni'mah is every good blessing that makes you happy. Everything that makes you happy is a ni'mah. Now, isn't everything that is happiness coming from Allah? As Allah says in the Quran, وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. Every blessing you have is from Allah. And Allah says in the Quran, if you were to count the ni'mas of Allah, you would not be able to count them. So every human being has been blessed with ni'mas, if you think about it. Even the kafir has some blessings from Allah. His existence, his food, his sustenance, the world around him. So when we are saying, oh Allah, guide us to the path of those whom you have blessed, there must be something more than the blessings of this world. Because even the kafir has the blessings of this world. So what is referred to in ni'mah? An'amta. What is the reference here? The Quran tells us. The ultimate ni'mah is the ni'mah of Islam. What is one of the final verses revealed? Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-islam dina. The ultimate ni'mah is the ni'mah of Islam. So when we say اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ, what we mean, O Allah, those whom you have blessed with submission to you, i.e. with Islam. So this is the أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ. And another verse in the Quran clarifies, who are those people أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ? Allah says in the, and how do we get to that stage? وَمَنْ يُطْعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ. Those who obey Allah and His Messenger, those will be the people whom Allah has favored. Who are they? النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ. Four categories of an'amta alayhim in the Quran. Number one, the prophets. Number two, the siddiqeen. Number three, the shuhada, the martyrs. And number four, the salihin. These are the four categories as per the Quran. Who are those whom you have blessed? Number one, the prophets. Number two, the siddiq. Number three, the martyrs. Number four, the righteous people. All of these, by testimony of the Quran, are those who are an'amta alayhim. So when we make dua, we want to be in that category. We want to be with the prophets physically. We try to be amongst the siddiqeen in our own lifestyles. We make dua to Allah to die the death of a shaheed. We want to be of the salihin. And these are the people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has conferred blessings upon. And by the way, a very interesting point here. Imam Fakhruddin al-Razi, the famous mufassir and the scholar, he was from what is now Afghanistan, from Herat. Imam Fakhruddin al-Razi, he has a very massive tafsir. And in it, he actually says, this verse, unbelievably, if you think about it, but yet, subhanAllah, he does it. This verse proves the khilafah of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. You know, the standard doctrine of Ahlul Sunnah or Sunni Muslims, we respect the Sahaba, we consider Abu Bakr to be legitimate, other groups believe otherwise. Fakhruddin al-Razi, he said, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ. He says, this ayah is an evidence that Abu Bakr as-Siddiq is a righteous man who deserves to be the Khalifa. And how did he derive this? Because by testimony of the Quran, who are those whom Allah has blessed? النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ. And who was the one whom the Messenger himself called as-Siddiq? Abu Bakr. We know from the seerah, Abu Bakr was called Abu Bakr as-Siddiq by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he said that Abu Bakr is of the people on the sirat al-mustaqim. Abu Bakr is of, radiallahu ta'ala, is of those people. And therefore, it is our iman and belief that we affirm the siddiqah, the sidq, if you like, of Abu Bakr, that he is the one whom Allah Azza wa Jal appointed as the legislator, as the person in charge after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So from this verse, he even derives something that proves, if you like, Ahlul Sunnah's doctrine. One final point also of theology, and that is, Allah says, an'amta alayhim, the one that you have blessed, i.e. with Islam. And therefore, any blessing of Islam, any blessing that we have, it is from Allah, not from me and you. When we believe this, and this is called in Arabic, qadr. How does anything happen? Allah's qadr. Allah has will that I'm a Muslim and you're a Muslim. Nothing happens without qadr. Allah says in the Quran, the Bedouins consider that they've done you a favor by accepting Islam. يَمُنُّونَ عَلَيْكَ أَنْ أَسْلَمُوا. No, Allah says in the Quran. Tell the Bedouins, you have not done me a favor by accepting Islam. Allah has done you a favor by guiding you to Iman. So an'amta alayhim. Why are we Muslim? Alhamdulillah, Allah guided us. It's not because I am good and you are good that I deserve it. No, Allah gave it to us, so we are thankful. An'amta alayhim. You have blessed, not the one I earn it and you earn it. Look at the story of the two gardens, the one in Surah Al-Kahf. The man says, this is mine, I earned it. And Allah showed him who earned the garden. How did he get the garden? No, any blessing that you have, it is from Allah. وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. Every ni'mah you have, it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, the ultimate ni'mah of Islam, it is also from Allah. And therefore, صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ. InshaAllah, tomorrow we'll conclude the surah and talk about the two categories that we don't want to be with. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
لا يزال الخير حيا لا يزال إن في الدنيا سلاما وظلال أخبر الأيام أنها في وصال قم بنا وانظر لآيات الجمال قم بنا وانظر لآيات الجمال.